Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the global launch of the COMPASS joint initiative between IOM and the Netherlands.
Migration is one of the most complex matters of our time. It can be an opportunity for all, but too often, it's an unpredictable and dangerous road for many. The road to safe migration lies in understanding its complexity. So, where do we start? Let's begin by understanding that migrants, like all human beings, belong to families, circles of friends, communities, national and global societies. All these levels affect decision-making. We need to address each one of them if we want to find a sustainable way forward. That's why we created COMPASS, a global initiative to protect the most vulnerable while guiding safe migration better together. We make sure that people on the move are safe and protected. And if they wish to go home, we help them return and face the challenges of reintegration. We also support governments and partners through training and coordination. Collect data to learn from our experience to better understand migration and inform new policy. Together, we have the power to make the cycle of migration safer. Join us.
Migration and forced displacement can affect every person, every country, in every time period, in every context. Therefore, the only approach to migration has to be a comprehensive and holistic one that takes every person and every context into account. We are very proud of this new collaboration with IOM that facilitates this effort and contributes to the protection of migrants and the prevention of irregular migration. COMPASS' strategic, knowledge-based and flexible programming is crucial to address all of the complexities of migration. This innovative way fits with the Dutch focus on knowledge-based programming and learning to contribute to better informed migration policies. We hope that the insights that will be gained on that COMPASS will also contribute to broader knowledge sharing. We look forward to further collaboration with IOM, partner countries, and other key stakeholders, and seeing the impact of COMPASS over the next years.
In IOM, we're really proud to be recognized by the government of the Kingdom of the Netherlands and governments and other partners we work with as an organization with the capacity and the commitment to undertake the broad scope of work under this initiative. This three-year program provides really a very important opportunity to support migrants, particularly vulnerable migrants, but also to invest in capacity development of local actors, as well as to strengthen the evidence base and therefore promote learning, which is so important to inform action. Over the past 5 years, we have really geared our efforts at IOM towards improving assistance to vulnerable migrants, combating trafficking and smuggling, assisted voluntary return and reintegration, awareness raising, data collection and analysis. And we have expanded these areas of work, not only providing direct assistance to migrants and partners, capacity building, but ensuring we are all working at all levels of interventions to support safe and sustainable migration, individuals, families, and communities, as well as local, national, and international institutions and policies. In the past years, we have developed the building blocks on which this initiative will stand, which are IOM's new AVRR strategy and handbook, handbook on AVM. We are developing new theories of change and models for counter-trafficking and are developing new guidelines and tools for case management. And all of these efforts are really consistent and developed in line with the principles of taking a rights-based approach, migrant agency, do no harm, accountability, the principle of engaging and empowering local actors, self-determination and participation. So So as you can see, we really want to make sure that IOM's ability to provide holistic and comprehensive support to migrant protection and assistance continues to grow and improve. And this is what the COMPASS program is built upon and will contribute to. So I'm very happy to conclude for the close partnership we have established during the design and launch of this initiative. And we look forward to continuing and deepening this partnership as we implement and learn from COMPASS.
My pleasure to tell you something about the motivations and ideas behind COMPASS before Heather introduces the program and its goals. So the Netherlands has a comprehensive policy on migration, and this means that we have a whole of government approach and that we look at all aspects of migration, which includes both protection and decreasing irregular migration. Now, IOM and the Netherlands have been longstanding partners in this, and with regard to migration cooperation, IOM is one of our most important partners. And this was reflected in the large number of IOM projects we have been funding. And together, these projects covered important thematic priorities of our migration cooperation policy, these being protection, awareness raising, countering trafficking in persons and smuggling of migrants, return and reintegration, and data collection. And geographically, the project spanned the MENA region, the Sahel, and the Horn of Africa, which are focus regions for the Dutch development cooperation policy. But because of the many separate projects, the cooperation between the MFA and IOM was fragmented, and it was an inefficient way of working. Because, for example, sharing lessons learned and best practices between the project was a manual exercise, and it was difficult to adapt the different projects during their implementation time to integrate new insights. So we wanted to improve the way in which we cooperate and pursue goals related to migration with IOM. And to do this, we merged the different projects under a coherent structure that's aimed at flexibility and learning. And this has become COMPASS. So COMPASS's coherent structure will allow us to better coordinate and align activities both within the program, but also with other relevant initiatives and partners. And COMPASS is also set up to be flexible, and this will help us to respond to developments and emerging needs and to ensure that we can continuously improve our activities based on the new insights that come from monitoring, evaluation and data gathering. Because COMPASS has large components aimed at evaluation, research and data collection, and that includes data gathering by IOM's displacement tracking matrix and an impact evaluation of the community-based interventions under this program. So this will serve monitoring and accountability purposes, but we also wanted to make sure that we use the information that we gather for learning. So COMPASS is meant to be a learning program that is designed to increase knowledge and the uptake of lessons learned, both within the program and beyond its parameters. So besides using the gathered information to improve COMPASS on a continuous basis, we aim to contribute to the broader knowledge on protecting vulnerable migrants and decreasing irregular migration. And we will do so by actively sharing the knowledge products and lessons learned, for example, documents on what we have found to work and snapshots. And with this way of working, we hope to achieve high quality activities. But the last and vital element of a successful program is, of course, cooperation itself. COMPASS is a partnership between IOM and the Netherlands, but to make it a success, to successfully and sustainably pursue goals like countering trafficking and smuggling, cooperation in a broad sense is important. And COMPASS takes the approach that recognizes that individuals, migrants, are part of social structures, their families, communities, and the broader society that is governed by the state. So the program is based on principles like ownership and participation from these migrants, their communities, and the governmental actors. And therefore, this program takes all these structures as well as the ownership of each actor and their participation into account. And to target these different levels, cooperation with a broad range of actors is necessary. And naturally, this includes the government partners in the countries with which we work, but COMPASS will also actively engage and work with local partners to benefit from their understanding of the local circumstances, politics, and culture. And it is for this reason that we've set up this webinar. We hope to attract your interest and pave the way for new and more cooperation to guide safe migration better together.
There we go. Good. So we're ready to start. So what I'd like to go over is the development process and really IOM's aims in partnership with the Dutch. So on the previous slide, we saw a nested egg or a, sorry, if we could move back to the previous slide. We are using in this approach what is referred to as an ecological model. I'm on the one with the ecological model. So what we're doing in this program is looking at all of the different levels of society, all of the different levels in which we think we need to take steps and implement activities to address migrant vulnerability and also to encourage sustainable reintegration. So one of the things that we aim to do with this program, in complement to the Dutch focus on learning, is to take IOM's recent publications and our recent learning and theories about what works best to prevent and address migrant vulnerability and to encourage sustainable and successful reintegration for migrants, their families, and their communities. And in order to do this, we are going to use an ecological approach. This is an approach that looks at migrants as individuals and has a good assessment of their histories, their situations, and the individual factors that may make them more or less vulnerable to violence, exploitation, and abuse, trafficking, or other forms of deprivations within a migration context, or the factors that protect against that, as well as those unique individual factors that we can mobilize for sustainable reintegration. And then also to move broader, to take a broader lens and to look at that individual as situated within a family and a community. Because our theory is that at these different levels, there will again be factors that promote sustainable reintegration, promote safe migration, or may contribute to difficult reintegration or to increase vulnerability. And these families, individuals, communities, of course, are situated within the broader social situation. So we'll also be looking progressively at structural level interventions, working very closely with national governments and our partners in the ground so that all levels are taken into account. On the next slide, or the previous one, I think I switched them around a bit with the three aims. So really the underpinning this approach is a whole of society approach. I think that's a nice link here, saying that we want to engage. This is not just the IOM program or the IOM and Dutch program or the IOM and the UN system program. There's a role for individuals, for migrants, for their families, and for their communities to engage in this program. Next slide. Thank you. So here, thank you. That's the one. So also service delivery. So this program is very much focused on directly engaging with migrants and working together with local partners. So IOM has a very comprehensive network of partners who work directly with migrants. And we work side by side, of course, with our government counterparts, who are also service providers for migrants. So we recognize in the program that migrants will have protection and other needs, and the program is here to help meet those needs. We also want to improve the capacity of partners to directly meet those needs as well over time, using an evidence-based and learning approach. And then back to the next slide. Here's eight key aims that we aim to achieve. We want to ensure that migrants are protected. Thank you. Through assisted voluntary return and reintegration. To the slide with the eight graphics, please. Thank you. Sustainable reintegration, anti-trafficking, anti-smuggling, using awareness-raising methodologies and underpinned with data collection and research. Next slide. Now, here are the four outcomes that we aim to achieve through the program. First, that migrants and their families are protected, assisted, and empowered to pursue sustainable resolution of vulnerabilities and reintegration. That at the community level, evidence-based comes first here for a reason. We really want to learn new information about how to engage successfully with communities so that we can mobilize most affected communities to welcome returning migrants and to support their sustainable reintegration. Two, at the community level, care for community members who have been affected by trafficking, violence, exploitation, abuse, or other harms from migration. And of course, in the first place, to prevent community members from falling prey to traffickers or to smugglers. At the higher level or the more structural level, we want to see a conducive environment for migrant protection, combating trafficking and smuggling, and promoting safe and dignified return and sustainable reintegration. And we aim to do that by working closely with their partners to build capacity, to ensure laws, policies, and programs are in place and are appropriate for achieving those aims. And underpinning, of course, all of this approach is our focus on improved information, sharing, learning, and coordination.
There is a question about the countries that participate. So if we can give an overview of the 12 countries participating. Heather, would you like to comment? How did we choose the 12 countries that participate?
Certainly, and I would invite Mariska to join as well. The Dutch did have priority countries that they approached IOM with, and then due to some pressing needs in the field, we were able to bring in two additional countries. So it was between IOM and the Netherlands addressing internal priorities. Mariska, do you want to say anything to that also?
Yeah, I think it was a combination. As Heather said, the Dutch migration cooperation policy has and the development cooperation policy has focus regions, which we established at the beginning of the period of our cabinet by looking at ODA criteria, and also specifically looking where Dutch aid has can make a difference. So we gave IOM sort of the framework and the priority regions, and then we established which countries we were going to engage in based on looking at the needs.
So what are the concrete activities that will be rolled out by the program?
Great. I think I can take that one as well. Sorry, I'm not looking at the screen because I have notes in front of me. So one thing I think to note is that it is a three-year program, and we have designed the first year's activities in detail. So my answer will not be comprehensive. Some priorities might emerge in year two and year three at the program. But at the individual level, two key types of programming is support for assisted voluntary return and sustainable reintegration, and case management for vulnerable migrants. So victims of trafficking, unaccompanied and separated migrant children, persons who have been smuggled and have protection requirements, et cetera, will be eligible for intensive case management services. Complementing that service delivery approach, then we will also have capacity building for internal and external caseholders. So concretely, we aim to launch a training program by September for everybody working with migrants under this program. And then towards the end of the year, doing follow-on training for other service providers, referral partners, et cetera, who might not be quite as embedded in the program. At the community level, this is actually pretty exciting stuff, we think. We are working with an external research organization who is going to help us use experimental approaches to community level programming. So because community level programming is fairly expensive, we are in the first year only focusing on two countries, that's Ethiopia and Nigeria. And we will select target communities that are affected by migration, and we will implement community level activities. These will include awareness raising activities, capacity development services for local actors, and community development programs that will support sustainable reintegration. We'll get that off the ground in the first year, but then we're going to be doing quite a lot of monitoring and evaluation work at the community level so that we can start to quickly identify good and promising practices for scale up in years two and three. Roughly, this is the priorities for year one, but progressively over time, we'll be doing more structural level programming. So next year, we aim to start doing the acronym MGIs, Migration Governance Indicators Assessments, to do comprehensive assessments of a government's migration management plans and capacities, and to start developing tailored response plans. So that's when we're going to work really a lot more closely with the national governments to see what their interests are at the structural level and how the program can best support them. And then, of course, underpinning all of this, we're doing a lot of investment in core structures that improve our monitoring, evaluation, data, and research capacities. So we are investing in MIMOSA, which is our system for tracking outcomes, really, of individual migrants, also facilitating service delivery, so we can hopefully provide better, faster, and more effective services. And also we'll be investing in the Counter Trafficking Data Collaborative, which is a facility for bringing together case data on victims of trafficking and other vulnerable migrants who have been assisted by IOM or other partners. And we will also be working with national governments in a few select locations this year to build their capacities in managing counter-trafficking administrative data. I've talked too much, but I think there was a lot of concrete stuff there.
Yes, thank you, Heather. I think that really was a good summary of everything that we are going to do in the coming time. I wish you all a very nice day. Hope you stay in touch with us and you follow us and you support our work. Thank you very much.